D-Rock with CMB TV here. We have Travis Meeks, Days of the New, with us. Thank you, Travis, for being here. Appreciate it. We got Chris Spools of Dark Thread. You might recognize him. He's also our gracious host tonight here at Herman's Hideaway. And we've got Mile High Underground as well in the house, man. Thank you guys for all being here. And, you know, let's see what's going on. So, welcome to Denver, first of all. First time here, or?
Oh, no. I've made little appearances from through the shadows, man. I guess this you haven't noticed, but yeah, I've been here many
times. A few times, right?
Yeah.
I know. Well, welcome back. It's good to have you. There's still quite a following here that thoroughly enjoy what you do and what you've given us. So, you know,
we just got to put the word out, right? You know, that's the key.
So just by the looks of the room here, pre-show rituals look to be gummy bears and Red Bull, huh?
Those are Spider-Man fruit snacks.
Spider-Man fruit
snacks. That is, let's see. A few years ago, I had some things that my taste buds have been changing over the past few years. So I was really into the Spider-Man fruit juice thing.
As far as new music coming out, I know you guys are throwing in a few new songs from, I think it's called Days of the New Presents Tree Colors. Yep. Is that correct? Still in production? You guys still writing stuff, recording?
Yeah. Well, the album's written. It's just what it would take financially to make it work. It's not something you can just put up in any studio and just do real fast. Mm-hmm. You know? Like Rage, you could do that. You know? He's got his Marshall amp, have a good mic or whatever, and, you know, that's simple, that's, you know, it's still art, but it's cookie cutter too.
When you're recording stripped down bare
what
bones.
What I'm doing is cello, upright bass, multi-instruments, Japanese koto, harp, ukulele, all these different kind of instruments that have to be, they need love. If you don't take care of that stuff, it's going to get tore up the first day. Because that stuff is alive. It stays breathing.
You planned to tour with that later this year, right?
Yeah.
Full package.
I'm moving to New York. I live in Salt Lake City right now. That's where I got clean 2005. I moved to Salt Lake from 2005 till now, and I've just been back and forth. From here to Kentucky to I went to New York for a little bit and rehearsed with the drummer from the second and third album, Ray Rizzo, but now I'm going out there to meet with the cellist and upright bass player and multi-instrumentalist, and we're going to take a little band out, and I'm going to release an EP first, basically, before the Presents Tree Colors.
How many tracks are on that?
5 to 6, and it's basically just acoustic. They're all shorter tracks. They're all kind of cutthroat, to the point songs, but they're a good transition from what I've done to Days of New Presents Tree Colors.
A lot of growth.
Yeah, I mean, that's the transition. If I just took you to Days of New Presents Tree Colors, you'd go, whoa, that's too much, you know.
We get a little taste of that tonight, I believe, don't we?
Yeah. But, so basically this is a transition, you know. It has flavor of the older rock, and now it's musical is all I can describe it. When I think of musical, I think of, you know.
Well, it's more than just bass and guitar, but speaking of bass, I know you had, it's tragic, but we lost Mike Starr last year.
Oh, yeah, a year ago today.
Yeah, you had him doing some tracks on this album.
He was working on going out with me, and he was going to try to be the guy.
Did he lay down any tracks on what you've got unrecorded yet? No.
Okay. Nope, didn't go that far, man. That's how burnout he was. I don't mean like burnout like it. I mean like just tired, you know? He wanted something to fix him, don't we all?
Right.
And a guy like that hit it hard for so long, battled with it for so long, his body was just tired. You know? It's nothing that has to do with morals or anything. It's just It just has to do with some people can hit it hard. I can't drink. I can't smoke pot. I wish I could, you know. Then I wouldn't think about some of the things I think about, maybe. I don't know. But regardless, whatever path you take, you know, people can work out all the time, and that could be annoying and overwhelming.
That can be an addiction.
Or people can, like, be, you know, too into computers, or people can be too into jogging.
Sex.
Or my wife's looking at me off camera going, yeah, you?
There's always too into something, you know?
Like, I got a question. What do you listen to right now? Like, what's your favorite record? Or
what's in your car, man?
Yeah, what are you listening to right
I'm
now?
I'm still listening to Dick and Dance, man.
Dick and Dance?
I've been listening to Dick and Dance since I was 16. But I listen to soundtracks. I try to take in the art so I can get inspiration from it. Because what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to... it's not that I'm trying to fit in. It's just the music that I'm doing. When I hear other people doing what they're doing, it's like, oh, well, there's my niche right there. Of course people would very much like what I'm doing if it's out there and, you know, and grabs. Are those Blue Vogues?
These are Doc Martens.
Oh, okay.
Those are sick.
Sorry. But, you know, basically, it's just I approach it such... from an artist perspective. Some people may call selfish. I'm guilty, you know, but whatever it is, yeah, I do got some mental disorders, and I've heard, don't we all, but you know, that doesn't help me, that
no.
perspective.
Is your, you know? Is your release when you get up on stage?
I'm whacked, man. I have to be an artist, or I'm just not gonna survive. Because it's my purpose, and I know that. So really it all comes down to a spiritual war between myself, drugs, life, people, getting along with society, you know, choosing my battles, relationships, you know, all the above. It's just a spiritual war. Some people don't believe in spirituality. That's their own problem, because I can tell you what, I'm taking care of you right now, and you don't even know it.
Is it something you think about when you're writing, creating, or playing the music on stage, how your music has touched other people, how it's helped them through hard times similar to yours? Is that something you think about, or is it something you try not to think about?
That's the only thing.
Realize that?
That's the only thing that makes sense. I mean, that's the truth.
You guys okay back
there? You know, when people share their experiences with me and their battles, you know? That's the only
thing. It makes it worthwhile.
It's true, yeah.
Very cool.
But I don't always have the time to do that, because right now I'm having to kind of start over to a degree and do a lot of things that I gain humility from. Humility is like the master ingredient to be able to hold any foundation. If you've got humility, step aside, I'll kick my ass. You don't need to.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Yep.
I don't need you to do it. I'll do it just fine.
Take care of yourself.
That's humility,
man. Take care of anybody else.
I mean, you can take it on. That don't mean that I'm going to sit there and be able to get through a hackler in the crowd easily. Mm-hmm. It doesn't mean it's not going to bother me. You know? It just means that, come on, be more creative than that. The shit you're saying to me, shit, you should hear what I say to myself. Mm-hmm. You know? So... anyways,
how has that changed as far as the songwriting from then until now? Has there been a growth?
Now it's everything's real. I don't question it. It's just all real. It doesn't even matter if I was to relapse right on drugs or if I write sober, you know? Because all first three records I written was all sober. And then the EP I wrote high.
When you write, intentionally go to that dark place? Do you try and sometimes just write some stuff that doesn't touch on that? Do you just write some...
I have a complex and...
little
yes.
shit that just is so
but
trite?
You know what? That's what it takes. You don't think Johnny Depp looks in the mirror and goes...
damn, I'm sexy.
Well...
don't we all do? I mean...
Yeah. We have to modify and deal with it in a healthy way. Mm-hmm. You know? I'm not for reality TV. That ruins.
I agree with you.
That's but you know what? I'm not going to lie. I like to watch it sometimes because I like to fill my head with negative shit because I'm a human being. But I also like to call myself on that shit and go, fuck, I'm watching negative shit. So I guess I like the process of being a human.
Now, to bring that up, you were on reality TV for a little while.
Yeah,
back,
I was.
About 7 years ago.
And that's done damage, and it's done good. It's helped a lot of people, but it's damaged my career.
Had it not been in the limelight of the face of the public, and had it been in behind closed doors, was it a positive?
I wouldn't have got clean.
No?
Because that gave me the humility I needed to be a porn star in my own world. If you don't have a balance of humility and giving it away and letting it be and letting someone else write the story for you and you play the character instead of being the god, and then, you know, you're always going to be trying to be thinking you're going to end up like a complex like these Bush motherfuckers. I'm pretty sure. I got a feeling, you know, that they're the people who want to control things. They do have a knowledge, you know. If you keep things from people, they're going to want to know what it is. Mm-hmm. They're going to chase it, and they're going to chase it, and they're going to chase it. That's my biggest problem. I am the fool. You know? I'm the fool. I'll go get high, and I will think that you've done something wrong, and I'll sit there and try to pick you out, find everything wrong that you've done in your life. And you're like, what are you talking about, dude? What the fuck? And that's just my own guilty shit for the shit I do. Mm-hmm. That's how it all works.
Push and blame.
But we do it to ourselves.
Yes.
It's like we're responsible for what we know, basically.
Exactly.
It boils down to that's pretty much it.
You know, they say if ignorance is bliss, I'm the happiest motherfucker on the planet, you know? I mean, sometimes it's the truth.
But, you know, I think we have to...
But there seems to be accountability there, so...
It's Adam and Eve eating the fruit, man,
Very well said.
If you eat it, you got to be willing to go through the process, you know? If good has to fucking take a break and be at peace after... the so-called 7 days, you know, or whatever, then that means that maybe we will have an apocalypse. Whatever. Probably so. But at some point, it's going to be all good again, because it has to be. There's no way that bad shit can survive without good shit. There's no way.
Cheers to that. Man.
It's just the...
Exactly.
It's the fruit of everything, you know?
All right, so as far as what's coming up this summer, have you got a pretty heavy schedule as far as touring, playing, whatnot? I know you want to get this album out. Days of the New presents Tree Colors. Going to be touring, pretty big support for that.
Basically, I know this is a very downer thing, and I mean, I shouldn't probably say it, but I'm going to say it anyways because I'm a fool like that. I open my mouth. But man, if I can't get this shit done in the next year, I'm just gonna fucking draw disability and be done with this and retire.
There's a lot of people that just side on that, you know, when they heard.
Dude,
that,
if so. I can't get this done, I'm too crazy. I'm whacked out. I'm not gonna survive. You know, I gotta keep my teeth in my mouth. I gotta have love for myself. And this kicks your ass is business. And if I can't get this music out within the next year, get some people who cannot get mad every time I get mad. Jesus Christ. You know, just let me be mad and walk away. You know, yeah, I'm intense and I get mad. You know, I'm like the devil sometimes. But if their egos can deal with it and they don't always want to be the rock star, you know, I'm given the creative role for a reason.
Yep.
You know?
Right. Yeah.
And just so many people want to just, really? So many people want to be me. It's just so hard to be me. That's the God's honest truth.
Oh, I believe you. You know, that's
it's the hardest thing I deal with, man.
That's why I'm on this side of the stage, because I've been on that side of the stage. Chris is constantly on that side of the stage. It's
well,
not an easy job.
In order to be me, you have to use crystal meth for 3 years straight, trip out at every end of the high, and go to the hospital swearing you're having a heart attack and you're dying. You want to do that?
No.
Believing you're dying for 3 years straight? I'm dying. Really believing it. That's horrible. Mm. You'd just rather die, right? And to believe it over and over and over again, that's hell. You'd have to go through some serious fucking hell, so no, you don't want to be me, you know? My wisdom was well earned, so fuck off.
Well put.
You got quite a legacy already, man. Like of what you've done, man. People hold you in
I'm
very high
regard.
I'm not
40 yet, man. I'm still in my 30s. I ain't even turned 33. So I'll be 33 next month.
I want to have you play here again, man. Bring you back out here. So.
Absolutely, man.
And here's a call to arms. You know, he needs some backers. He needs some people to help him out. Let's get Travis Meeks, Days of the New. Let's get these guys back. Let's get them stronger than ever.
Absolutely.
You know how to get a hold of this guy. He's got his Facebook page, Days of the New. Find him on the website, TravisMeeks.com.
You probably won't talk to me. You probably talk to my beautiful wife.
Who, manager?
So to speak.
Handler, keeper.
Let me ask you this. What advice do you have for these up-and-coming bands that have been on the path or trying to get to where you've been in a positive outlook in music?
I'm a dying breed, bro. There's nothing I can tell you, man. It's over for the old blood, man. And if you got grandparents or you got a connection with your fathers or blood or something that makes you connect with something that you think is God or think is something, maybe you don't like God, the word God or whatever it is, if you feel something, follow that zone and fight for it. You're going to do it anyways, man, whatever the cost is, you know. But if you don't believe in it, then there's no point in doing it. You're wasting your time because you're going to end up having to go to law school or something.
Yeah. Well, you've heard it from the horse's mouth, Travis Meeks. I've earned this wisdom, so fuck off. Fuck you. Travis, it's been a pleasure to sit down here and talk with you. I appreciate you coming to Denver. Rocking Herman's Hideaway here on, what is the date today? March 8th. Colorado Music Buzz issue release party with our phenomenal guest, Travis Meeks. Thank you for being here, man. We appreciate it. Mile High Underground.
Herman's Hideaway.
ColoradoMusicBuzz.com. Thank you so much. Congratulations to you. Welcome back. It's good to see you,
Travis, thanks for keeping it real, dude.
Yeah, buddy.
It's refreshing, dude.
Thank you.